to Sets Off California, and this is the Lamb Five Show, and I'm Giassi Harper.
And I'm Eva De La Rosa. We're broadcasting live from our Lamb Five studio here on campus. So, Giassi, how's your Valentine's Day?
Very fulfilling.
Nice.
I had a lot of chocolate, had a lot of candy that I regret eating.
Well, good for you. That's
great. Play a lot of video games. Slept. Yeah.
That's nice.
Well, anyway, stick around to hear about the 2.5-mile long carpet.
Also, a police officer played basketball with kids and brought a nice surprise.
Did you go skiing in Big Bear this weekend? You may have just missed an earthquake if you came back today. Stay tuned for my weather report.
We want to hear about Kobe and the world basketball game.
What he said, yeah. Okay. Am I supposed to say something to you?
The movie A Monster Calls is coming to theaters.
We have that story and a lot more on the other side of the break. Stick around.
I am Tesla, California.
I am Tetzlaff, California.
We are Tetzlaff, California, fam. We are Tetzlaff, California.
I am Tetzlaff, California.
Hello, Tetzlaff Trojans, and welcome to Book Talk. Today, we'll be talking about Roller Girl by Victoria Jameson. This book will also be sold at the book fair on February 22nd to March 1st. Crossovers, plow stops, backward skating, these are just three maneuvers you will find yourself practicing after you lace up your roller skates, put on a helmet, and zoom into the fast-paced sport of roller derby with 12-year-old Astrid. The game does not come easily, she stumbles and falls, gets bruises and bumps. Many players would throw in the towel, but not Astrid. Thanks to a big heart, a positive role model, and her good friend Zoe, she gets back up again and again, and shows the value of hard work and perseverance. So, this is Jane Gopuli here, and this is Book Talk.
We're back, Trojans.
It's time for the Tetzlaff play-by-play.
Tetzlaff is an old backpack school. Several students have been seen during passing periods and other times wearing or carrying backpacks. The small cinch bags tend to be the biggest violators. Please don't bring any backpacks to class. They can be sent to the lockers, however. Students will receive a tardy slip back to your class.
Get your ice cold water at the studio store that comes with a free flavor packet with each bottle purchase. The price is just a buck. The studio store is open during lunch when the cafe doors close and after school. So quench your thirst at the studio store for just a dollar and pick a free flavor packet with every purchase. Also, if you collect enough bottle caps with letters to spell Tetzlaff yearbook, you get a free yearbook. Look for other prizes on the bottle caps as well. Last Thursday, Tetzlaff had the Valentine's Dance. Let's see what Live and Five reporter Julian said.
Oh shoot, I didn't see you there. This is Julian Jang, reporting for the Live Vibe Show. I'm over here at the Valentine's Dance. Let's take a look.
Do you have a Valentine?
No, I do not.
No, I'm alone this time. I don't know how to reply to that. No!
What is your favorite part about the Valentine's Dance?
Well, I'm glad that there's not much people here, so yeah.
Because I want my Valentine.
Why did you come to this dance?
Because all my friends were going and it sounded pretty cool.
I'm with my Valentine.
Well, I'm working the photo booth, so yeah.
Do you like the idea of the Valentine's dance?
Yep, because I get to spend time with my Valentine.
What do you think about the music choice?
The music choice is pretty random, but it's pretty cool as well.
It's good.
Do you like the idea of the Valentine's dance?
Yeah, I mean, they got a different theme this year. They got glow sticks, so.
What is your overall opinion of the dance?
It's cool.
I would give it a 7 out of 10.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good.
Hey Trojans, it's Julian here again, and the Valentine's Dance is over. Everyone seemed to enjoy it, and yeah, that's it for this package. See you guys next time.
Come and check out yesterday's Action and Reaction Prank segment. Let's check it out with Moses. Hey guys, it's Diaz here with another freezing parody. If you guys get what I meant by freezing, then you probably know what this parody is about. Well, let's just check it out anyway.
The snow glows white in New Jersey tonight, not a tank top to be seen. A kingdom of refrigeration, and it looks like I will freeze. The wind is howling and I need to get inside. Any longer now and I'll get frostbite. Don't let cold in, don't let us freeze. Be a good girl and go turn up the heat until the chill leaves with the snow. We're Eskimos. It is cold, it is cold. Can't go outside anymore. It is cold, it is cold. Run inside and slam the door.
It is cold! But did you know the movie Frozen made $1.2 billion? So basically, they won the lottery. That's really what it is. That's it for this week. I'll see you next week with another freezing cold parody. Well, it may not be cold, but that's your hint. Yeah. See you later. Sorry, that was actually today's Action Reaction segment. Well, that's it for the Tets Off Play-by-Play.
We'll be right back after the break.
Hello, Tets Off Trojans, and welcome back to another Good Talk. And today we're reading How Hardy by Jessica Cora. The daughter is with her 16-year-old Sarah has grown up far from civilization in Africa's Kalahari Desert. Animals are her only friends, and just seeing a person reminds Sarah of her mother's death. As part of a grant award, her father agrees to host 5 teens on a conversation exchange program. When he leaves to search for poetry timing for Silver Lion, Sarah is in charge. But she soon learns that they are also the poetry group, and Sarah is infected with a virus, and there are only a few hours to get help or she will die. This is Kalahari. This will be sold at the book fair starting February 22nd to March 1st. This is Samaj Estel. I'll see you guys later.
Hey guys, it's Jaden here to inform you that we want you to get on the air. So send us your pics to Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Facebook, and Skype. You can also watch us on YouTube at TetsLoveCA. Make sure to tag us at hashtag TetsLoveCA. Keep sending us the pictures all year and we'll keep putting them on the air.
Does a home for the poor really deserve the red carpet treatment? On February 6th, the president of Egypt rolled out a 2.5-mile long red carpet during an event to open a house for the poor. The president, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, has been criticized by many for his use of the rug, but he has been supported by his military spokesperson, Ilhab al-Kwawaji, who said, quote, "It has been used in all state celebrations. It gives a good impression to the world. It is then removed and used in other celebrations. It's not costly," end quote.
5 years later, and the cleanup is still in progress. Fukushima's nuclear disaster occurred on March 12, 2011. The cleanup for the accident may take up to 40 years. The people preparing the nuclear reactor are making slow progress. It happened almost 5 years ago and killed more than 15,000 people. Their biggest obstacle is removing all the melted nuclear fuel debris from the 3 reactors. Time to check in with David on a Day's Entertainment Report. Oh, yeah.
thank you. I see. I'm not gonna do that. I'm sorry. What? I can't. The TV's right here, so I can't put them. Entertainment news today is a monster calls. It's about a 12-year-old boy named Connor. Connor is going through a tough situation with his mom's illness that has not gone away for a while. When he goes to school, he has to deal with Sully, Anton, and Harry, his bullies. Every night, Connor is visited by a monster. Connor believes that the monster is there to help his mom heal from her sickness. Could the monster be here for a different reason? Watch the movie on October 14th or the big bad monster will get you. Oh, okay. Let's see what's going on in the world of weather. Good morning, Victoria.
Good morning, it's time for your earthquake update. This morning in Big Bear, California, there's a 2.6 earthquake, and in Mexico, there's a 4.8 earthquake this morning. Our pollen index for today will be a 9.3. Moving through the week, our high will be a 10.2 this Friday. Here in Los Angeles, it will be very sunny today. Moving up to the north, it will be partly sunny. In the Midwest, it will be very sunny, just like here in Los Angeles. In the east, partly sunny, and down in the south, very sunny. Our high here in Los Angeles will be an 85. Moving up to the north, they'll be looking at high 40s and low 50s, and okay, and 19, which is weird because the rest is like low 50s, and then there's low 20s, and then 19 degrees. In the Midwest, they'll be looking at, here in the Midwest, they'll be looking at high 40s. In the east, high 20s and low 30s, and down in the south, high 60s and low 70s. It's time for our 5-day forecast. Today's high will be 80 and our low will be 58. Moving through the week, our high will be a 90 today. Don't forget to send us your birthday pics and your social pics. It's now time to check out the Daily Web Poll with Jace. Good morning, Jace.
Thank you, Victoria. Today we have Mensu with us. Good morning, Mensu.
Good morning.
So, Mensu, how's Tetzloff treating you so far?
Pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I really like Tetzloff. Would you mind reading this week's poll for us?
Should Tetzloff charge a fine for overdue library books?
Sorry, it's okay. Here's what some of your viewers said. Yes, because the people that have overdue books should learn a lesson by paying for their books. And another student said, no, because some people don't have the money to pay for their overdue library books. To vote, visit us online, live5show.com. If you want to hear your opinions on the air, simply direct message us on Instagram at TetzloffCA. So, Mensu, you think we should charge library books, or for overdue library books?
Yeah, I think we should. Like, if you don't, people who have overdue library books wouldn't, like, return it.
Yeah, they don't have anything to motivate them to turn it in. Yeah. That's it for the Daily Web Poll. It's time to check out Sports with Araj and the John.
So I'm just gonna leave it off to John. So I'm not gonna be doing the sports for a while. So yeah, I'm pretty sure you guys are gonna be happy and stuff. So yeah, Jace. So see you guys next time.
Hey, this is John, and it's nice to be back. We hope to see you again, Arash. And this next sentence will be sad for you Kobe fans. Anyways. It's Kobe Bryant's last year in the NBA. In his game on Sunday, when he played for the NBA All-Star game, the West won 196 points to the East 173 points. It was a score of 23 points apart. The West demolished the East with a score of 193. Once again, it is nice to be on the show. And that kind of wraps it up for sports. Let's toss it off to our Daily 411.
Thank you, Dijon. Well, you'll be missed, Araj. I'm sorry Jace had to do that to you. But anyway, what was the name of the first video game console to use disc discs for video games. Atari 2600, SNES, TurboGrafx 16, and PlayStation 1. Take 5. Okay, well anyway, released in 1992, the TurboGrafx 16 was the first video game console to use disc for video games. Time now to check in with the last story of the day with Eva.
When Florida police officer Bobby White got a noise complaint, he and his partner pulled up to the address and saw kids playing basketball. Instead of scolding them, they joined in and played. They said they would be back in with reinforcements. Joining them on the return the next day was 7'1" Shaquille O'Neal. Better believe it's Shaquille. The kids were so happy when they saw him. After playing a round of basketball with him, he happily signed autographs. The officer said, quote, "We're going to let kids be kids." Well, that wraps up our show for today. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a great day.
First time we met, you was at the mall with your friends. I was scared to approach ya, but then you came closer.